Hi, I'm Adam, and welcome to First Man Photography, and welcome to the world of water drop photography. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to shoot some of these amazing images of water drops and everything you need to do it. But before we get into that, if you like this video, please give it the thumbs up at the end, and that really helps me out. And if you haven't done so already, head over to firstmanphotography.com, fill in your details, and I'll send you the free copy of the ebook on how to capture exposure perfectly every time. Okay, I'm going to show you today two ways of doing this. There's going to be a basic setup that's a lot cheaper and a lot easier to do, and then we're going to move on later to a more advanced way of doing things where you're going to need to invest a little bit of money and a bit more gear. So, what are you going to need? For a basic setup to shoot some still beautiful images, you're going to need a few basic things, and I've got them on the table just here. The first and most important thing, obviously, is the camera. So you're going to need a camera, and ideally you're going to have a macro lens. It doesn't have to be a macro lens, but if you use a normal lens, you're probably going to need to crop it a fair bit to get a similar sort of looking image at the end. So it won't be quite as good. Some macro lenses are fairly inexpensive these days, so that's something you might want to look at. Next off, the most important thing is we're going to need a flash. Now, these can be very cheap these days. If you buy them secondhand, you can get them for just a few pounds off eBay. We're going to be shooting the flash in manual mode, so you don't need, if you buy one secondhand, you don't need to worry about all the ETTL systems and things which usually bump the price up. So a very cheap flash will do, and you're going to need a flash trigger as well to shoot, because we're going to be shooting off camera flash. And we've got an example here of remote triggers. This one attaches to the flash, this one to your camera, and one triggers the other. You can also use a wired solution, but you need to have that off camera flash. Next, what can be useful is a trigger for the camera, so you don't have to touch the camera to fire it. These are really inexpensive. And I've got a clamp stand here where our water drops are going to come from. I'm going to hang just these plastic bags filled with water onto our clamp stand, and the water's going to come from there, and it's going to fall into this bowl, which is when we get set up is going to be full of water. And importantly, we've got a towel to clean up any of the mess, and very vital as well is this pen, and we're going to use that for focusing. I'll show you that in a minute. Also, I've got some food colouring here, which is going to just add that extra interest to our water drops and produce some colour, some beautiful colour in our images. So, let's get into this. I'll get set up and we'll go through it. Okay, so here we have our setup. We've got our water bath set up, and that's full to the brim, and it's inside another bowl to catch any of the overflow. You want it full to the brim so you get that really nice infinity look in the final image. So I've got the camera set up with the remote trigger on top. I've got it set up on a tripod, which I didn't mention earlier. It's not entirely necessary, because you can prop it up on the table or some books, but a tripod is really going to help you out and make your life easier. We've got the flash set up nice and close, so it's going to light our image really nicely and give us a really nice, bright, well-exposed image. We've got the clamp stand here with the water bag that's going to provide the drops into the water, and all we need to do is take our pin and simply push a little hole into the bag, and that's going to produce the water drops. Okay, so now we've got our nice drip going, let's talk a little bit about the camera settings. It's the flash that's going to be freezing the image as opposed to the shutter speed on your camera. For an explanation of why that is, if you go to the description below, I'll describe it in there in a bit more detail. But for the sake of the video, we've got our camera set at f11 for the aperture to give you that nice big depth of field, and because we're quite close in, you need a high aperture. We've got our flash set at 1/32 power to give you that nice quick flash to freeze the image. And shutter speed is set at 1/200th of a second, which is the sync speed for this camera. And ISO is set at 400. And they're settings that have always worked really well for me. You can experiment with your own settings or follow them for your own images. To add some extra interest to our image, I've produced this blue background and that's set up as the background to our image that's going to add some colour and interest. All I've done is printed that off with a blue colour and onto a piece of paper and stuck that to the background. So the next thing we need to do is to focus. Now we've got our drip going, it's landing in the same place every single time. So all we need to do is take our pen and you place it into the water bath at the point where the drop is landing. Next, we go over to our camera. And in manual focus, we're going to focus on the pen just like that. And then when you start dropping, you're going to have a nice focus on your drops. So there we are, we're ready to shoot. So I'm going to get down to this level so I can see the time, so I can get the timing right, anticipate when that drop's going to fall, bounce back up, and I'm going to capture that shot. So let's shoot. That's not a bad start. Happy with that one. Okay, we've got some nice shots there, but I'm going to add some colour to the water bath, to the bag, to produce some colour and add a bit more interest to the images. So let's do that now. Okay, so we've got our colour set up. Let's shoot some more colour images. Okay, I'm happy with that one. Okay, so we've got some nice images there. You can really go to town on this and experiment yourself. You can use different liquids like milk or oil, and they're going to add a different consistency to the drop, and it's going to produce interesting and different results in your final image. You can use different colours, different coloured backgrounds, and really see what you can produce. Okay, so let's move on to the more complicated setup with the water dropper. Okay, so here we are with our more complex setup. All that's changed is I've put this electronic water dropper in place of the bag. Now this is the SplashArt 2, and what it does is it produces two quick drops that are going to hit the water, collide, and produce that beautiful crown effect in your image. We control it with this unit here, and you can control the size of the drops, duration between the two drops, and the timing and when your camera fires, because it's plugged into the camera and fires the camera for you. So you get a much more consistent results. The SplashArt 2 is produced here in the UK, and I'll put a link down below to take you over to the site so you guys can check it out for yourselves. Okay, now let's get to shooting. All you need to do is once you set up, you've got your adjustments made with your settings on the device here, and you just click the button here and it fires and produces, hopefully, those really nice water drop collisions. So let's just shoot a few. I'm going to get down so I can see. That looked like a good one. Yeah, very happy with that. To get more consistent results as well, you can put your camera into mirror lockup mode, which is going to just arm the camera ready. I don't bother though, because it works quite happily without that. So as you can see, much more consistent results, really effective, and a really nice device to use for getting your water drops.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed that introduction to water drop photography. It really is just a case of then going out, shooting some yourself, and seeing what you can do. Experiment with the lighting position, the backgrounds, and the different equipment that you have or you want to invest in, and you're really going to get some beautiful images. There's lots you can do in post-processing as well to adjust things, change the colours, and sharpen things up, which is really gonna enhance your image as well. I'd love to see some of the things you're creating, so if you head over to Flickr, upload your images and add them to the First Man Photography group, I'll take a look at them and then I'll feature some in the comments below and on social media. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it the thumbs up, and if you haven't done so already, like I said at the start, head over to firstmanphotography.com, fill in your details, and I'll send you a copy of the ebook on how to capture perfect exposure every time. I'm Adam, this is First Man Photography, out.